Welcome back to Pathologic Classic HD. We've just spoken with the Superovs here, and they told us about Yulia, who lives across the river, who may be able to shed some more light on the death of Isidor. So let's go speak with her. Apparently she's one of the few rationalists in this town. I guess she's someone who does not believe in clairvoyance or astrology or anything like that. Which does indeed seem to be rare for this town, because most people do seem to believe in that stuff in this town. Very superstitious. Let's see if I've got any empty bottles to fill up. Nope. It seemed like my quest for today was so simple I wasn't worried about time, because it seems like time passes so slowly, but now it seems like I have a lot to do today, especially if I have to find the killer before nightfall, otherwise I'd die. If that is indeed true. Hello.
There are unseen connections looking through the capricity and tenuity that the world seems to be made of.
I seem to have lost any capacity for observation. My mind is out of tune. Things no longer add up. Before, I had no trouble forming a trustworthy tessellation of the most imperceptible contingencies. Now, I simply cannot get my head around it. Could it be that I am dying? Yes, it definitely means you are about to die. Jesus. That is my opinion as a professional doctor. It happens when people are tired. You probably haven't slept for a while, have you? Oh no. Herba... I don't know how to pronounce that. Herba... Virene? Is in blossom, I grant you. But then it blooms every year. Every year the steppe is filled with its stupefying vapors. The issue I'm having, however, has nothing to do with fatigue or perplexity. It is just that I've lost my ability to make distinctive events coincide. Wait, so there's something that's blooming every year, and every year the steppe is filled with its stupefying vapors. Are you saying there's a plant that's making everybody strange around here? Is that the plant that I keep seeing in people's homes? What herb is that? No matter what pre-natural traits that the locals ascribe to it, twire is all heady aroma. A bunch of superstitions and remarkably little else. It has psychoactive properties, after a fashion, but then so does simple wormwood. Visions caused by ingestion of belladonna or jimson weed are much more fascinating than what twire has to offer. It's a pity I'm not a botanist.
There are unseen connections looking through the capricity and tenuity that the world seems to be made of.
So, you have traveled all the way here only to find that both people you wanted to see were brutally murdered. Is this how the story goes? I do hope that your visit is not in any way related to these most unfortunate circumstances. I have to find whoever it is that killed Isidor and Simon, and I wanted to ask for your help. Superov told me that you have a gift for all manner of investigative inquiry. I'm certainly no better investigator than you. I never had a chance to search for a murderer before. The best I can offer is to fill in the blanks with whatever mysterious supernatural entities seem most fitting. Shabnak Adir's the simple man's scarecrow. I would have followed a different narrative. What kind of narrative? Consider the circumstances of his death. They said Simon had locked himself up in the evening, and consequently died in the morning inside the mansion, in a chamber with some peculiar name. In this case, I would suggest that Simon was poisoned. By the Canes, I would have thought. But I know their family all too well. Their mutual loyalty is only rivaled by their arrogance towards anyone who is not one of them. They hold the princely sage who stands at the head of their family in highest esteem. They believe that a single dishonorable act will tarnish their name for generations to come. I doubt any of them would have stooped to this. No matter whether they wanted to or not. Poisoned? How did you arrive at this conclusion? I don't believe you understand what "he died in focus" really implies. Do you know what the Canes refer to as focus? You don't seem to grasp the semantics of the term. These are the Canes for you. These kind of innuendos are their forte. Well, what is this focus, then? The focus is anything but an abstraction. Quite the opposite, in fact. It is governed by mathematically rigid regularities. You see, no one but the owner of a focus may get inside. This can only mean that Simon had brought the killer with him, or rather, within him, since no physical object may be brought into focus, either. Right, the focus. The place that no one can ever really enter accidentally. Right, people can't just sneak in. Unless, of course, they're inside of Simon, as she said. How do you know that? Who doesn't? The Canes are notoriously passionate about all manners of synthetic anomalies. They will never pass up the opportunity to devise a Kunstuck. What? I don't know if I pronounced that right. That is not an English word. That would allow them to warp space, challenge physics, or manipulate optics. Metaphysically, a focus can be compared to a camera obscura. Do note that the name is not unfitting. No, it is entirely impossible for someone to get inside. What? A curious conclusion, but an incorrect one. Simon was disfigured and bleeding. His bones were broken. Is that so? Well, this does introduce a different perspective. Did you say Isidor was the last person to see Simon? The question is, who did he see before? The sun had not yet set when Isidor returned from the steppe. However, he came to Simon well after midnight. The question naturally arises, where did he spend the missing few hours? That is why I'm trying to trace Isidor's steps. I want to walk the same route. Don't get me wrong, though. Was Isidor seen with Subarov, by any chance? He was. He warned Subarov of an upcoming storm. All right. Let me suggest, then, that while he was in the steppe, he saw or learned something that he wanted to report to all three ruling families. In this case, either of the Olgimsky family should have been on his itinerary, especially since Barak was one of their own men. Really? Definitely. The Bull Project, from the abattoir to the railway, is controlled by the Olgimsky family. If Isidore's discovery had anything at all to do with the kin, Isidore would have certainly related to Vlad. So do make sure to pay a visit to the Lump. That's the name of the Olgimsky mansion. Another fitting name, wouldn't you agree? Thank you, Yulia. What would I do without you? This is the Lump. What a great name. It even looks lumpy, just from an overhead view. Hey,
this girl is a changeling. She's not the murderer.
Oh my god, there's like a million more things I can ask her. Oh god, how do I get out of this conversation? Let's just ask a question. Do you like Ava Yan? Very much. it wouldn't be much of a stretch to say I absolutely admire her. Huh. Weird. I expected you to have a different opinion of her. She dons the mask of absent-minded promiscuity, but this pose has nothing to do with what she really is. I'd be happy to be friends with her. But she does not understand me. And rightfully so, considering her eminence. I can't believe my ears. Sooner or later, a fervent believer may emerge from within her, dissolving her completely in the object of her adoration. After which, she will probably kill herself. But I'd rather talk no more of that. What? She might become a fervent believer. And then after that, if she becomes a fervent believer, she'll probably kill herself. What? Okay, that's bad. She's on my list of people that I need to save, right? People that I need to make sure don't die. Who might she become a fervent... Who or what might she become a fervent believer in? Because I guess I want to stop her if that means she's going to kill herself. Alright. Okay, let's go speak with the other ruling family. She said that there were three ruling families, right? So I guess I've almost spoken to all of them. I've spoken with the Kanes, that must be one of the ruling families. I've spoken with the Superovs, and then I guess the third one? The final one is the Ulginskis. Alright, well, I'll go speak to them in just a second. I'll be right back. Alright, so let's go follow in Isidor's footsteps. We believe that they've visited the lump, so let's go check it out and see if they've said anything interesting to the Ulginskis. Might take a look at the town hall along the way, too. Ooh, looks like I just picked some nuts off the ground or something. Hazelnut. I really can't waste time, though. Yeah, okay, I'm not gonna stop at the town hall. Let's not waste any time. If there's time left at the end of the day, then maybe. But I'm still not sure how many things I have to do before the end of the day. So let's not risk it. I've seen this person. Or creature. I guess it's famous. I wonder if I can get its autograph next time I see it. Ooh. Okay, now I've got to definitely have enough sharp things to trade for some medicine. In fact, you might have some. What's in your pockets, pumpkin? Oh, nothing. What about you, kid? Nothing. This looks like the place. The old Gimsky's place. The lump. Is this it? Mm-hmm. What time is it? It's 1 p.m. Hey! They've got a picture of, one of the unfinished people. The cattle herders, right? That's what they do? Lovely place you have here.
Lucky people are bad hands at correcting their faults. They always believe that they're right when fortune backs up their vice or folly.
Ah, Bachelor Dankovsky, of course. Who else could be so dapper? I've heard quite a lot about you. Have you taken a look around? Be sure to check the state of the industry around here. We have our own ways. Let's try not to piss him off. Seems like a very serious dude. I mean, Jesus, look at his eyes there. Look at his eyes here, too. And look at that. That's the same plant that we've seen before, right? The one that gives off a vapor? How curious. And what is the current state of your industry? Come now. It's a complicated establishment with 1,000 years of history. A special approach is required to control such a colossus. See where I'm getting at, emissary. It would be pointless to object. I can see we're not really seeing eye to eye. The project is special. Very special. That means common standards do not apply here. That would be very naive. We'll come back to that.
Someone will have to be punished for this sin.
Yes, getting everything back on track won't be an easy task. I'd like to inquire about the fate of my colleague, Isidor Barak. About the manner of his death, to be precise. What are you implying? What is this manner you're talking about? Be so kind as to mind your own manners. I had nothing to do with it. Don't they say Isidor was murdered by a step demon? A Shabnak Adir? There was that thingy. A talon they fished out from the wound. I'm sorry, I can't take this guy seriously with that serious face and that serious voice when he says thingy. There was that thingy. A talon they fished out from the wound. Yes, the thingy. He's awfully defensive for someone who's not been accused of anything. That's suspicious. I can take this from kids and weirdos, but you, a respectable negotiant. It's hard for you to believe, isn't it? It used to be hard for many. Take my boy, for example. A scoffer if I've ever seen one. And now even he believes it's real. He went off his head a bit. You're in the steppe now, esteemed sir. Eastern and backwards. The dead rise from their graves here. Clay dummies dance, and bulls talk. Does he know the steppe well, that son of yours? He rubs elbows with the rabble, the butchers, Odong, shepherds and gatherers. Learns their tongue, collects their legends. He doesn't keep them in check at all. They even dare to come visit him within the premises of the town. If you see a worm creeping through the streets, he's definitely looking for my son. I have seen a worm. I thought the worm was like the name of just the person, but I guess they're all called... They're all worms? Every single one is a worm? Perhaps I should go speak with them. What's wrong with them visiting him within the premises of the town? They're dangerous, they're aggressive, and they hate everyone. Who isn't a step person? They'll jump you and kill you on the spot. They'll tear you up with their teeth and devour your flesh while you're still throwing fists at them. So if they're spotted within the town, countermeasures are taken. So, what of your son? Perhaps he could tell me more about this creature. Hold your horses. You want to talk to my blockhead? No, you have nothing to talk about. He's not here, thankfully. I don't want you two to meet. You heard me? These are tradesmen's words, and I'll stick to them. I just makes me want to talk to him more. but I'll play the game with this person for now. Yes, undoubtedly. That was not a very fruitful conversation. There's gotta be more, right?
No. I won't believe in some earthen killer.
Wait. What was that sound? I just realized there is a sound. Did it just mark something on my map, or was that like a quest thing? I'll check after the conversation. How do you think Simon died? I don't think he was murdered. How could he who craved monocracy not perish? He couldn't, not in this place. Balance requires equilibrium. So Simon's course of action contradicted yours? Come now, what I'm saying is, when someone takes too much upon themselves, they always end up ground down. That's how life works. Yet they say Simon was the one to bend the circumstances, not the other way around. No one seems to doubt that. Simon has lived a very long life. Very long. He was a worthy man. But long doesn't mean eternal, does it? No one is to blame for his death. Examine the body. You'll see it for yourself. It just happened. Cain won't let me examine the body. Well, that is temporary. A family tradition. He's not lying to you. He truly believes Simon was murdered. Were he to admit that Simon simply died of death, he'd probably go to his last home himself. The shock would be too much for the man. That's strange. Georgie Kane didn't appear sentimental to me.
Fortune turns all things to the advantage of those on whom she smiles.
Okay, saying this might piss him off, so hopefully not. Isidor came by to see you last night. Don't try to deny it. So what if he did? I'm also aware of what you two have been talking about. All I want to know is why he left to see Simon afterwards. Oh my, oh my. Pray forgive me. So, he wanted to bring me to heal. That traitor. That bastard. Well, what he asked for was for me to stop the factory. How could I not kick him out? What were his reasons? His reasons? Huh? The bastard! He reasoned he'd pay a visit to my daughter. He knows full well how to pull my strings. Well, I told her to lock the door. So away he went, none the wiser. Oh, the bastard. So he went to Simon, huh? Thank goodness my loafer of a son is hanging around somewhere. Or else, he could've... Could've what? Huh? That, my dear and respectable friend, is none of your business. My property, like I said, is in order. See the skin and meat delivery reports. Do you know how hard... No way. It's my domain, whether anyone riots or not. And I'll have my way with them. I see, I see. You're the big guy here.
What?
Yes, it will be hard. Alright, so it looks like that's it. So yeah, did it mark something on my map? No. I really want to go inside. Have I been given permission to visit Isidor Barak's place? I don't think anybody actually gave me permission to go inside yet. Hold on, has anything changed with my quest? The older Olgimsky does his best to avoid any mention of his household. When I asked him what his son was doing, the honorable stockbreeder momentarily lost his temper. I think that the son knows just as much as the father, and it will be easier to get him talking. But where can I find him? I have no idea. He hangs with the rabble, right? It wouldn't happen to be the man with Worm, would it? the man over here? By the pond, next to Ava's place where I slept? I do want to go speak to the worm again. Hmm. I wish I could ask him again where his son is. Or just ask him again about his son, see if there's any clues specifically to where he is. Also, there's something very strange about this place. And what I mean by that is... Oh, hey. Psst, hey, over here. Hey, wait. 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 Come back. Talk with me. Can I talk with you? I can't talk with you, can I? I think I'm supposed to chase him. What I was going to say is strange about the building is that it's really tall. The lump. It's a very tall building and there's multiple floors, but for some reason, there doesn't seem to be an entrance to the second or third floors. Wait, hold on. What the hell? I didn't think they'd try to kill me. Well shit, I don't have any choice but to shoot them, right? I just wanted to talk! Where are we? The windows of this house are bricked in. Hold on, I think I can ditch him if I go inside. Yeah, whew. Yeah, that's gotta be him. Are they gonna attack me as soon as I go outside, though? Hello? I've got a gun. Good, they're gone. Whew. I didn't want to have to kill them. Oh, what the hell? Have these been filled with blood? We're near the train station, right? The railway station, yeah. Hold on, I'm gonna go talk to him in a second, but I saw something over here. Yeah, what's this? Just, some fires ready to be lit. They almost seem like signal fires, sort of. Hmm. And there's a pathway that leads out there. And there's symbols out there. I wonder what would happen if you actually went out there. Hmm. Well, again, I'm relatively limited for time, so... If I have time to explore later, maybe I'll go check that stuff out, but for now... Gotta finger the murderer before nightfall, I guess. Alright, you must be the son.
Katerina thinks Claire is a messenger from heaven. Yeah, right.
Yeah, this is him, Vlad the Younger. You found me here. Oh well, I'm not surprised. I suppose you're not too surprised by the fact that everyone knows about you, either. The rumors of your arrival spread like fire. Why have you come? I've come for some sightseeing? That's not true. There was a peculiar incident yesterday by the spleen. The children were playing in the mud as usual, but then suddenly they ran away from the sandbox, and the parents noticed that their hands were smothered in blood. However, none of them were wounded. Neither were any of them surprised. What? What's the solution to the puzzle? When the worried adults came to the place where the children had been playing, we found nothing unusual there, only sticks and stones. What do you make of it? You children play peculiar games. Nice to meet a person of a skeptical mind. I'm Vladislav Olgimsky, the younger one, of course. And you are, of course, Daniil Denkovsky. Nice to meet you.
It is easier to govern others than to prevent being governed.
Bachelor, I have news for you that should prove to be of interest. You seem to be looking for the killer, right? I'm listening. I'll have to briefly explain a few things to you. Have you already been told what the termitary is? No, I haven't. The termitary is a huge bunkhouse where the bull project workers live. Although living is the wrong term for it. They nest. They're nesting as a commune, with a rather simple way of life. It could, without reservation, be called savage. What's the Bull Project? It's the whole industrial system of the town, from the abattoir to the goods station. Would you care to listen as to why I wanted to see you in the first place? Very much so. Please go ahead. Let's get to the point, then. A case of pointless, aimless unrest has occurred in that hive mind's nest. The workers there are prone to lashing out from time to time like beasts frightened by a storm. They rage, they howl, they gnaw at one another. An unsightly image of a mass uprising. What does this have to do with Simon's murder? Riots have occurred in the termitary several times before. The mob goes crazy for a few days, then they calm down just as unexpectedly. All of them, at once. The sudden calm is just as void of reason as the unrest that had set them agog previously. Having a certain experience with the kin, we simply block the entrance to this zoo off until the riot defeats itself. What is this kin? The kin is... well, doesn't matter. It's hard to explain. Their whole so-called society. The many-headed biology. Yeah, I have no idea what that means. Very well, let's get back to the subject. We usually lock them up beforehand. The evidence of an upcoming outbreak of mass lunacy becomes obvious in advance. In the termitaries, Father Superior informs us of it. But Father Tychik has recently passed. A curious coincidence, don't you think? Mass anarchy. Anyway, a member of the kin managed to run off into the town while we were busy taking measures. You think he's the killer? I think you and I can help each other, Doctor. You're looking for the killer, and I'm sure it's a runaway butcher. The title of a half-man suits him very nicely. The Canes claim that Simon had not been killed by a human hand, don't they? And our family doesn't need unnecessary unrest in the town. This butcher can babble devil knows what. His mind is most likely clouded with insane ideas. Why is her family so concerned about public order? Because we are rulers. It has nothing to do with charity, trust me. We are in charge of production, after all. If the unrest becomes serious, the factories will stop. The project will start failing. And we have contracts. We would lose money. I'm surprised I have to explain this to you. I understand. So you don't want the runaway to spread unrest among the already scared townsfolk with his words, right? You are correct. They barely know how to speak. But that only makes it worse. Half-men, half-beasts. If they start preaching, you feel as though you've encountered a doomsayer. I need this butcher to disappear. Hand him over to the Canes, or simply kill him if the beast attacks you. The reward will be hefty. I'd rather not kill him. So, is that the worm that I just found? Is the worm that I saw by the pond, around where I woke up and started the game at, was that the same worm that I saw running from the Olginsky's house? The same one that just tried to attack me and try to come here? Alright, very well. I'll look into this. Where can I find him? He's most likely being harbored in a suspicious house. That's in the crude sprawl. Yes. My father is a man of rather hard-handed disposition, and quick-tempered to boot. If he finds out the crude sprawl is concealing a fugitive, he will make a mess. Pointless brutality serves no one. I'm looking for peace rather than blood, I'm telling you. I'll do my best to make sure you're right. Show me the house. That's it, huh? That's pretty far away. Okay.
It is easier to govern others than to prevent being governed.
Alright, but we're not done speaking. What do you think about Simon's death? It is known that Simon had limited his social activity just before his departure. He only received 2 visitors. I know nothing of the first, but the second was none other than Isidor Barak. The fact that he was killed the same night makes you think, doesn't it? Oh, looks like there's a misspell in the text there. Oh my god, this game is horrible. I'm gonna uninstall it immediately. Where isn't... No, it's... Even with one spelling mistake, the translation is slightly better than it was before. I'll take a spelling mistake or two. I feel like I shouldn't say the second option. No, I'm not gonna say it. I don't want to piss him off or show my hand too much or something like that. No, let's not do it. The killer took out a witness. Or an accomplice. Isidor was a complicated man. Have I told you about his position in the kin? He used to be a very well-respected person there. And I can't say everyone liked it. Okay, I'm gonna play my hand a little bit here. Your father didn't, did he? You are correct. I am willing to admit it, as you can see. Were I not absolutely positive that my father is innocent, I would have never confessed to it, even though we share a mutual distaste for one another. Father needed Isidor. He was of much use to him. And that is the ultimate argument in my father's favor. Was he useful as a healer? Isidor wasn't a doctor. He was more of a herbalist. He never studied medicine. All his recipes were about plants and roots, so to speak. He was knowledgeable, true. A sorcerer, if you will. But a very different one from Simon. An earthen sorcerer. I've never heard that Simon used to be a sorcerer before. Well, wait, that's not true. I have heard. Didn't somebody say that he's a sorcerer? I don't remember who, but I think somebody did. Simon was a theurgist. Hope I'm pronouncing that right. Isidor was a witch doctor. And you think Isidor the witch doctor has managed to achieve the unachievable? A possible theory, but rather questionable.
Katerina thinks Claire is a messenger from heaven. Yeah, right.
I know it's ridiculous, isn't it? What are you talking about? Vlad, now tell me. Did Isidor visit you last night? Tell me the truth, please. Yes, Isidor did pay me a visit. But don't ask what we talked about. I have no right to share that with you. The first one's a little bit too hostile. Let's go with the second one. That is because that would make you betray your father, isn't it? Yes. Seems it's better to put the cards on the table with you. So far, you're coming across as a very smart person. You've talked to my father already. What do you know? I don't really like either option. Guess I'll go with this one. Everything. Almost everything. All I want to know is where you come into play. Isidor said, note that I'm merely retelling it secondhand. He said there's an epidemic in the steppe camps. An outbreak of Tarbigan? Tarbigan sickness, perhaps. The plague, that is. Father had issued an order to lock the termitary up to prevent the infection from getting in. Epidemic in the steppe camps. Where are the steppe camps? What are the steppe camps? Do you think Isidor had already been infected when he spoke with you? He was wrapped in a cloth and smelled of spirit. He said these were preventative measures. But I still think he could have done all that just to convince me, after failing to convince my father. It was idiotic of me to fall for it. Or maybe it was true. And maybe Simon did die from this plague. Although, I don't see how a plague could break your bones. So he could have already been infected when he visited Simon. We need to warn Reuben. It's very urgent. He is about to examine Simon as soon as the period of time required by the canes passes. But where is he? I have no idea. Where's he staying? I don't know. There was a secret dissecting room in one of the warehouses. But no one knows where exactly. He used to live mostly in the steppe, sometimes sleeping in the termitary or in Lara Ravel's shelter. But he's not there, I know that for sure. He went away to mourn his master. What would you have done if you were him? I'd check every warehouse, of course. Perhaps I'd find something.
We promise according to our...
Let me just check around here and see if there's... anything. I want to look down there. How deep does it go? Ah, freaking barbed wire's in the way of my head. Is there anything up there? It's strange that there'd be a ladder, but you can't actually go up all the way. Ah, well. Not gonna happen. Let's make sure Worm is not waiting for me out here. Okay, so what do we need to do now? We need to examine the warehouses, right? Where are the warehouses? Factory building. Would it be red? The warehouse where the urchins under Chiefkin... Oh, so this is the warehouses. And this is the Castle of the Soul and the Halves. Yeah, so that's where one of the, like, gang member leaders lives. And these must be the other warehouses, which is actually very, very close by. I'm here, and that's just right there. Let's check the quest thing and make sure that is one of the things I can do. It is highly possible that Simon died to some unfamiliar disease. Stock Rube and the town medic should be warned at once. If he touches the body, he may contract whatever disease still remains there. Okay, well, I have to hope that I find him at the warehouses. Because if I don't, then I have no freaking clue where to find him. Well, I think I'm going to visit the warehouses in the next episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.